Welcome to the Carrier Update presented by AT&T Business. Today I wanted to talk about the Northeast market, generally a backhaul market. It's a market where carriers try and avoid. What I've got up today is a couple of heat maps for you to look at. On the far side here is the heat map that's the outbound tender market share index. Most of these smaller markets up here in Augusta, Maine, closer down to Boston, Springfield, Albany, New York, they're in the sort of less than half a percent range. They're fairly small markets. But one of the reasons that carriers try to avoid this market is because there's less freight coming out of these markets than going in typically. It makes it a low head haul value. It's not until you get back down here around Elizabeth and Allentown and PEA that you find some bigger markets. So carriers tend to avoid these particular markets because there's not much coming out unless you want to run all the way up to Caribou, Maine and into New Brunswick where there's French fries that are frozen that are coming out from the potato harvest. So generally it's an area that carriers try and avoid. When you have a look here at the head haul index, you can see that Boston has gone deep into the head haul territory today. It's red, whereas Elizabeth, New Jersey, that we want to focus on today, is much bluer, which means there's more freight coming out than going in. But what I want you to have a look at here is the market table that we've built and shows that as you come further south, the head haul index starts to change. So it goes from deep 60s, where Boston is today, which is a deep backhaul market, less coming out than going in. When you get down here to Elizabeth, New Jersey, you can see it's at 83.14. So when you get to zero on the head haul index, that means it's a balanced market, about the same goes in that comes out. When you start to get into the plus regions around 83, that means there's a lot of freight coming out. And that's what part of the story is today, that there's a big shift on the east coast of the United States. If you look at the port of Elizabeth and New Jersey, some of the terminals around New York City, there's a lot more freight coming out of there right now. Their freight volumes have gone up. If we can have a look at the next chart, what you'll see is that this is the background here, which is the darker color, is the head haul index for Elizabeth, New Jersey. So it's gone from being a zero at the start of the year, fairly balanced market, to being a very strong head haul market. And that's got a lot to do with the increase in containers. Now, one of the ways we look at the import business is we look at the number of shipments that are in each container. You can have multiple shipments per container. So this particular index here is the monthly customs invoice shipment ticker that tells us about the volume of shipments coming in from the import side. And you can see this has increased about 45% year to date. So that as the volumes of freight come into the port, it's driving up the outbound tender volume for the market and creating it more of a head haul market. Now, for carriers in the Northeast that are looking for head haul loads out of markets like Elizabeth, you've only got to run 2 or 3 hours out of New England to find freight in this particular market. If we go to the next chart, what you'll see is that here, this is the loaded TEUs into New York, New Jersey. It's up significantly since the quiet period here. But what's really important is that the volume of containers coming into the East Coast in New Jersey has now surpassed the volume of containers to the West Coast over here. So the green line is the Los Angeles market. And this darker background here is New Jersey. Why is that? Well, as the trade war has dragged on with China, shippers have had to realign their supply chains to Southeast Asia countries away from China. What that's meant is that for the shipping lines, it's actually easier and quicker to travel west through the Suez Canal to the East Coast than it is to travel east to the west coast of the US and around the Panama Canal up to the East Coast. So it's quicker and more cost efficient. What it means is for carriers, more freight is landing on the East Coast than ever before as a result of the trade war. It's forcing more volume into the market. So if I was a carrier, what I'd be looking for is more freight volumes coming out of this particular market. The most important statistics out of this whole analysis is that about 80% of all imports that come into Elizabeth, New Jersey, move within a few miles to just four counties. So about 80% of the imports into New Jersey goes to warehouses and distribution centers in just four counties around Newark. Why that's important? You've got about 90 million people, or a third of the US population, within a 500-mile drive of that particular market. So carriers need to be aware of the shift as a result of the trade war that's going on and how freight patterns are moving from the West Coast to the East Coast, because it's what it's doing is it's changing the backhaul nature of the Northeast market and dragging it to being more of a headhaul market. So it should be a market that carriers should be looking at. If I was a carrier, I'd be watching the import volumes closely, because that would be my signal towards growing truck volumes.